What I do is just like you know, you know what I mean? Like
hey, what's going on? So just at the bench here, checking out the axe. If you do want to get one of these, I suggest doing a few of these moves to increase its performance. Because out of the box, they're bad. Like, super bad. So, just to show you here. Brass wheels. Lead insert weights. So that thing's coming in at 71 grams right now. That is a must. You are going to need that. Like, no ifs, ands, or buts. You're going to need heavy, heavy wheels. Just because this thing's got so much top heavy weight to it. Next thing I suggest is cut out this. This is the battery and ESC holder. Take the ESC out of its housing. Because that thing's actually got some substantial weight up top. You're going to want, like, this is like a must. You got to get another ESC, preferably in Fury Tech, because they're just all around the best. Get a tiny battery too. So this thing fits perfectly. I'll just kind of get it there. Fits nice and low. Like, you can see how low that thing fits. Like, this is the top level right here where my two fingers are at. Right there. You can see how nice and low that gets. So that keeps its center of gravity down much farther than that big, bulky, crappy battery that it comes with. So if you do all this stuff, just kind of tuck everything in as best you can. Oh yeah, don't forget, you got to bend your back housing, back body mount, so you can actually get full extension. If you don't do that, you can see that it'll just end up hitting your ESC, or your servo in the back, sorry. So that's like a must as well. A lot of people are going to run bigger tires. I chopped off the lights and trimmed the body. Nice and round, either side. Put a little tape on the inside to get rid of its noise. Added some lead up front servo, keep it pinned down, move the body, or the shock mounts, they were up here, closer to the inside. Sorry, scooter going by. I put them down lower, so it creates much more stable ride. Up top, it's goofy and it's dumb. I don't know why they put it up there. So those are a few things I'd do. Just out of the box, before you even run it. Anyway, gonna go take it to the back course there, see how it does. Alright, here's a look at it once it's all put together and whatnot. I do trim the body here, as you can see, just that little bit, so it hits over the steering horn, servo horn. See how nice the trim job is, if you're gonna run 64 mil tires. You're going to need to do that, or it's just going to rub the body. Moving the shocks like that gives you an awesomely low CG stance. Like, it doesn't get much lower. Like, what's that, a mil or two? Just from pushing it. I do run the rubber bands around the servos and the body mounts. The body. Yeah, I guess that's the body mount. Works pretty good. Get your tons of twist. Nothing's held back. So, let's go see what she's got.
So this thing is brushed, right? So it is going to have its stall out points, which sucks. But it runs so much better than the stocky SC with the FuryTech Lizard Pro. So much nicer. This shock placement, it still gets pretty good twist, even though they are stock shocks. Crazy twisty line. That's awesome. So the glad went down here yesterday. Let's see how this thing can do. Put a roller on it. Oh, that was terrible. I think it's too low. Oh, not bad. Decent.
Peace.